Today, we're going to be talking about how to wrap your ads with Ezoic code as step 2 of the setup process. It is important that you follow this procedure for every ad unit that is on your current site so that we can turn it into a unique placeholder. For the traffic going to the original site, these will be ignored and your original ads will show exactly as they are right now on the site. For the percentage of traffic you send to Ezoic, these will be transformed into placeholders where we can test new ad combinations. Now, as you can see, I am currently on the Ezoic dashboard homepage. And to wrap my ad, I'm going to go down to this ad tester app for this example. I'm going to pretend that I'm wrapping an AdSense ad in the top sidebar location of my website. Because it's an AdSense ad, I'm going to click Add Display Ad Unit. However, please know that you have other options here, such as native ads and link units. After clicking on this, you'll be able to choose where on the page the ad will show. So again, for the example, I'm going to remain with the sidebar top, and you can title this placeholder whatever you would like. I'm just going to replicate a sidebar top ad here for the example. Next, you see what device should see this ad. I always recommend that you choose all three devices. We can later go back in and edit any of this after the setup process, but it's always best to start with all three devices on all of this stuff. In the middle here, I wouldn't worry about doing anything or making any adjustments. These are all things, again, that we can go back in later and edit. For now, go ahead and just leave things as they are down here. We're going to choose what size of ad we want to test in that location now. Again, since I'm testing a sidebar top ad, I'm going to ignore the horizontal column, for example, and I'm going to choose all of the boxes. All of our buttons, and then all of the vertical sizes as well, you can go through and you can choose depending on what the location suits your site best. These are also things we can go back in and edit later on, so don't worry too much if you feel like we're choosing the wrong size. After you choose your sizes, you're going to click Create Ad. What's happening now is that it is going to give us a code. Now, you can see we have a code that was created for that ad unit. The next step after this is to go into where you have your ad code currently. So, for example, if you are using WordPress, you might log into WordPress and go to where you have your current AdSense ad code. We're going to wrap this code around where that code is located in your site. Now, I'm going to switch screens here and show you an example of what that would look like. Some of this code is going to be put in front of the AdSense code, and another part will go at the end of your AdSense ad code. So let's say, for example, that this highlighted area is where my code is in WordPress. I'm going to take this portion of the code that I just got from Ezoic and put it in front of the code. And then, where this end div is located, is where I'm going to put the rest of that code, at the end of my AdSense code, so the whole thing, in total, should look like this. And then you save it. Now your ad is wrapped. To reiterate, this does not change your ad by any means. For all traffic that is funneling through the original setup of your site, your ads will be seen as normal. It will just turn where that ad is located into a potential placeholder for all traffic coming through Ezoic. If you have any further questions on this process, please feel free to reach out to the IT team through support@ezoic.com. Or reach out to the account manager you are working with directly. I hope this was helpful, and until next time, enjoy using the Ezoic platform.